So today I am going to talk about why I am personally boycotting buying new Magic cards. I do have old Magic cards that I'm buying to do openings with, but I'm just going to boycott the new ones, which means you should see very little Lord of the Rings. You should see very little new sets, and just not really interested in Magic at this point in time. But the boycott is really based on the economic and financial situations of local game stores that they cannot survive. Number one, there are too many products, and if you bet on Aftermath and you have a persistent in that product, it's kind of bad. It's not just kind of bad, it's really, 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 really bad. And the reason that it is so bad is you lost money. You lost money. Right now, that is a set that sells for less than distribution on TCG Player as of the making of this video. So number one, people are not buying it. Number two, you're losing money per box that if you do sell it to get new cash flow. There have been sets in the past like Dragon Maze, which have absolutely devastated people's stores when they went deep in that set and it turned out nothing was valuable. And anything, the one card that was valuable, Voice of Resurgence, was just reprinted anyway in the new Master set. So it just killed. The price of a box is still very low. Even Return to Ravnica is still $100 a box at Steel City. So, I mean, it's a pretty big vendor. My boycott really has to do with, I think Magic is, at some point in time, the players have to take a stand. I think it was Aftermath. So, in the beginning, we didn't have mythics. Then we added mythics. Okay, that's fine. We had 36 packs and we had one box. So there were two type of cards, foil, non-foil. Easy for me to understand, easy for a store to understand, done. And maybe there was a third type of card, pre-release, right? The pre-release foil would go less than the regular foil, but a tiny bit more, sometimes the same price, depending on the playability of the card, as the non-foil. That's all good. That's all understandable. I think you guys understand that. I understand that. It's easy. Then they did set, and then they did draft. Then they did the collectors. The collectors, I still have a big problem with today, because that is 12 packs versus 36 for three times the price, or two to three times the price, depending on market price. That's an awful idea. That is an awful idea. I never liked that idea. I think it really, what's gonna happen is what already happened. It will push the price down of any, so the draft is now basically even less valuable, and then the set is like even less valuable. It's, you are segmenting the player base by how much money they make. And you might say, oh, we're segmenting by the type of player they are. Yes, 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 I get that. But you're segmenting based on price. Okay, understand you're segmenting based on price, right? The collector's edition is more expensive than the set. The set, less packs, therefore per pack more expensive than the draft. Then they had Jumpstart. And you might be like, oh wow, Jumpstart. So they have Jumpstart for various sets. Then they have Aftermath, which is a very micro, it's a mini, I mean, I don't even know what you would call a micro set. I really hate this ice cream truck, and goddamn, I don't know what the hell's going on. It's just driving around in loops. My neighbor has been building his pool for like 5 months now, and it's been construction from 6 a.m. until like 6 p.m. a day. I have no idea why they're so incompetent, but they are. I mean, there are some days that, because I like work and I look at them, that they literally sit there and then they just like pretend to work by making loud noises. I kind of live in like, I definitely want to sell my home and move to like a better place. I feel like this place really sucks. This is like totally off tangent. But anyway, let me go back to, not a fucking machine, ice cream machine. Boycotting. Oh, now they have these, now they not only have a collector's edition, they have a special edition collector's edition for Lord of the Rings. It's just like, it's needlessly segmented for no reason. You know, people say, oh, Magic 30th is a bad thing. Oh my God. But like, and then, so the $250 for a box of for a pack of Magic 30th is bad. But you're gonna pay for a booster box of basically six cards or five cards a pack. Like for Aftermath, I don't get it. So I don't really understand why people are not more offended by the fact that the prices continue to climb, the cards, literally the amount of cards you receive per pack continue to decline. You know, there's something that, I mean, yes, I get, there's no commons in Aftermath. Oh, fantastic. But what's a common? A common is just something that you made up, right? A common could be uncommon if you wanted it to be. It could be even rare if you wanted it to be. I just think that in terms of new players, it is just very sad to see what's happening with this game. So what I am saying very simply, if I go to a restaurant and the food is four times more expensive and the quality, and they give you less food than before, and the quality is even worse than before, the artwork and the creative, would anyone still eat at that restaurant? If Wizard of the Coast was a restaurant and Magic the Gathering was, you know, a meal, would anyone pay for this? Or Magic cards were a meal, would you pay for this meal? You're getting one third as less, and then per pack, you're getting one third as less per box, so you're getting one ninth less cards, I think, if that math works out, for three times the price. You're paying 27 times what you used to pay for worse artwork, worse foiling, just ugly, ugly cards. No, you gotta draw the line. Soon they're gonna have like two pack cards, three pack cards. I mean, you really want this to happen? Do you really think Aftermath, Jumpstart, all these additional things, the variants, I mean, for such a small set, why are there so many variants? I don't understand. Like, maybe I'm old, maybe I'm a dinosaur, maybe I just simply do not understand. And maybe that is probably the reason. That is the reason. I don't get it. I truly don't understand how we can support a company that I believe is giving us worse product for more money and making higher margins than ever before. You don't need to take my word for it. You can look at their accounting books, right? I mean, it's, I bet you, I mean, the only thing making money for them is the Magic cards. And because of that, they print even more of them. I don't know. I don't think it's investable. I don't like it. I don't like it at all. I don't like anything in Magic recently at all, because it's just, I know what it used to be. And I know what it could be. So to see what it is not great. Anyway, let me know what you guys feel in the comments below. Hi, guys.